thine anger, neither chasten me in thy hot displeasure. Have mercy upon me, O Lord, for I am weak. O Lord, heal before my bones are vexed. My soul is also sore vexed, but thou, O Lord, how long? Return, O Lord, deliver my soul. O save me for thy mercy's sake. For in death there is no remembrance of thee. In the grave, who shall give thee thanks? I am weary with my groaning. All the night make I my bed to swim. I water my couch with my tears. Mine eye is consumed because of grief. It waxes all because of all my enemies. Depart from me, all ye workers of iniquity, for the Lord hath heard the voice of my weeping. The Lord hath heard my supplication. The Lord will receive my prayer. Let all my enemies be ashamed and sore vexed. Let them return and be ashamed suddenly. I have read Psalm 6 in its entirety. May the Lord have a blessing on the readers and the doers of his holy word.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Church, we gotta lift up the man of God. Come on, we can. Thank you. Oh! Praise it, I'm gonna cry. Yeah. I know church wouldn't be right if we didn't sing that song. Victory song.
Show forth my death until I come again. Let us drink.
You're the Graduated
graduated with Sean from Fremont High School, but went to Morris Brown with me. Was in a bad car accident where the tractor trailer ran into a wall. The trailer came loose, went across the side of the freeway, and instantly killed my boy who played football with Sean. Was a graduate of Morris Brown College from Oakland, California. Larry Thomas. I've lost two classmates this year from Morris Brown who went to school with me, and both of them are from Oakland. So it just doesn't stop, y'all. You got something, some problems with somebody, y'all may want to get it right now. Breath in your body. Because the death angel can come at any given time. There's a movie starring Jamie Foxx called Any Given Sunday. It's a good movie. But the Lord and Savior don't just come on any Sunday. He can come on any day. He can come any time. He can come any moment. And it's his prerogative. I ain't saying you're perfect. Just be forgiven. There are sins that we know about and sins that we don't know about. And some folk have been taught so wrong when it comes to eternal security and salvation. They want to suggest you going to hell. You don't know where people going. God didn't say something.
Amen.
God didn't say nothing. You don't know where people going.
Amen.
Let me say it one more time, and then I'm gonna give clarity. You don't know where you're going. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 9, verse 27, as it is appointed unto all men once to die, and after death the judgment. So whether we go to heaven or hell, we got to stand to be judged for our good and our bad in front of God. And God only has two sentences. Y'all want to hear the two sentences? Depart from me, you workers of iniquity, for I never knew you. That's sentence number one. Uh-huh. Sentence number two is, come into my kingdom. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Amen.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All this old crazy teaching, you do this, you're going to hell. You do this, you're going to hell. You do that. You don't know. You're not God. This ain't my sermon, but I just thought, since the death angel comes a lot around the holidays, I thought some of us would maybe want to try to get a few things right before the holidays approach.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
10 years working in the funeral business now. It may be quiet in September, it may be quiet in October, but November, December, January, February, all funeral homes are busy. Anchor out there, it's up to you. If you want to drag the anchor, you want to put it in your spirit. They got nothing to do with Psalm 121, but it's just good information. We're standing for the reading of God's word.
Amen.
Psalm 121. I will lift up my eyes to the hills, and whence cometh my help? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. And then allow your foot to be moved. He who keeps you will neither slumber nor sleep. Behold, he who keeps Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. He shall preserve your soul. The Lord shall preserve your going out and your coming in from this time forth. And even forevermore. That's Psalm 121 in its entirety. And this is sermon number 3 today. I entitled this, Help Us God and Keep Us God. I have been preaching this for 3 weeks now. And the Psalm 121 is really a blessing to its readers. It's really a blessing to those. It's catching back up, those of you in social media. Again, it's not our fault. We apologize, but it's not our fault. This Psalm 121 is a song of degrees. It is a psalm that pilgrims sang as they were marching their way up toward Jerusalem for the Feast of the Booths, the Feast of the Pentecost, the Feast of the Tabernacles, and the Feast of Passover. Those were three times a year that they would march up to Jerusalem, and they would sing this song because of the dangers that was hid in the hills. And as they sang these songs, it was some encouragement to them because they knew that their help came from over and beyond the hills.
Okay.
I'm not gonna be long. I got a party to go to. She's party ready. And so as they would sing these songs, this song, they would sing this song as encouragement to them. Uh-huh. Verses 2 through 4, I told you 3 weeks ago, that was point one, the Creator will help us.
Right. Yeah.
The Creator will help us. Amen. He will help us. Yeah. Creator will help us. He knew, David, the psalmist, knew that it was some false, wicked doctrines and idolatry in the hills. And their help was to look beyond what was false, over and beyond what and that is true. God is the only person that cannot lie.
Amen.
Will not lie.
Amen.
Will not change.
Yes, sir.
Will not double talk.
Amen.
Okay, you can't say amen. No. He will not forget about us.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
He will not leave us.
Amen.
He will not forsake us. He knew that our real help came from above. This is David encouraging his disciples. I gave you that 3 weeks ago. Then last week I gave you point two, verses 5 and 6. His courage will strengthen us. His courage will strengthen us. He will strengthen us and protect us from our enemies. But then I told you he will protect us from the elements. Remember, our enemy is Satan. He ain't your friend.
Not at all.
Amen, amen. I gotta stay there. I'm trying to cut across the field, but I gotta stay there. He's not our friend.
No, he's not.
No, he's not.
And some of us spend a whole lot of time flirting with him. And it does not lead to anything positive.
No.
It only leads to destruction and doom and defeat. 3 points. It leads to doom, destruction, and defeat. That's what the devil does when he comes in your life. He makes it gloomy. He makes it dim. He destroys lives. He does not construct us. He destructs us.
Amen.
He's trying to tear everything down that you build up to. To keep you firm and to keep you stable. And the Lord knows, just like David, the psalmist knows, that some of our biggest problems, I'm about to preach right here, y'all, some of our biggest problems and our biggest issues and biggest people and biggest person is you. We are sometimes our biggest enemies. Some of y'all ain't never forgive yourself. Some of you looking at people to forgive you and people to validate you. For validation, you'll be waiting until Jesus comes. How you gonna get validation from people that don't even like you?
Yeah.
Oh, y'all spend a lifetime trying to please people that you would never please. I know some ladies that are in abusive verbal and physical relations and won't get out. A man ain't supposed to talk to you any kind of way. He ain't supposed to call you names that start with B and rhyme with itch. Come on, talk to me there, somebody. It gets real quiet when I start doing talking real good like this. Get out now before you die. Get out now before I be watching you on Fatal Attraction and fuck my name. Get out now before it get worse. It ain't gonna get no better. I don't care how many times he apologizes. I don't care what kind of flowers he buy you. They can be orange, red, purple, green, yellow, blue, or white. Whatever color he buy you, that Negro still ain't gonna stop. Because when the devil got a strong hold to you, the only person that can help you is God. I'm talking to somebody and you can't say amen. The only thing you can say is ouch. Lord, protect us from our enemies, but some of us like being in enemy territory. I know you're supposed to keep your enemies close, but some of y'all keep your enemies too close. They shouldn't hear you breathing. They shouldn't be able to smell your breath. Talk to me, somebody. They shouldn't know what mall you at. You should not put your locations everywhere you are, where your phone is. People get killed like that. Where you go is your business. I bet you ain't got your locations on when you sneaking and you with that woman's wife or that woman's husband.
No, Dr. Location is not on.
Some of y'all ain't got your location on while you sitting in church. The safest place. When we want to flunk, we got our locations on. When we don't be in the closet, we turn them on.
Ain't that what they do?
See, some of y'all can't say, man, I'm looking for the people who don't do that to holler back at your boy. I don't know if it's Bible, but there's a cliche say God protects babies and fools. Look how foolish I've been. I thank my brother Lex for helping me, because the rest of y'all was like Shirley Caesar in Temptation. Y'all sitting over here and moaning. Y'all can't help me, because the church is in moaning. Y'all will catch that tomorrow. Go on, watch it again.
I love that one, Doug.
Fighting Temptation. Watch it again.
That's my favorite one. Mm-hmm. You.
Lord, protect us. I ain't the only one that has done crazy stuff. I ain't the only person that have been places I shouldn't have gone and been with people I shouldn't have been with and said some things I shouldn't have said and hooked up with some people I shouldn't have hooked up with and drank a little too much Moscato. Talk to me, somebody. And some of that gin and juice. And smoke one too many trees. And tried this one too many times. Yes, sir. I ain't no street person, but I'm streety.
Wow.
I just made up another word again this Sunday. I'm on the road.
Yeah, yeah. I'm streety.
I'm from 107. I'm from Stone City. I grew up in the bottoms. I grew up in the flats. I've seen people on drugs. I've seen people get killed. I've seen people drop out of school. I've seen people forsake their family. I've seen people that was on drugs when I was a baby, and now I'm 53, they still on drugs.
Wow.
And I ain't by myself. Some of y'all still got some people out there right now. You've been praying and praying and praying, and the more you pray, it seems like the worse they get. Well, get it out of your hands and put it in God's hands and quit stressing over grown folk that's going to kill you. And you're going to be dead and gone, and they still going to be here. I wish I had somebody helping me preach it. I'm feeling preachy now.
Come on, preach. Come on.
Somebody just lift your hands and shout, I thank you, God. Okay, let me see if I can find about five of them. Somebody just lift your hands and holler long you can. God, I thank you I ain't still out there. I thank you I ain't on drugs. I thank you I ain't an alcoholic. I thank you I ain't homeless. I thank you, God. You look beyond my faults and see my needs.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Oh, I thank you, my thank you. Event. I gotta stand in nobody but God. Shake somebody's hand or touch somebody's shoulder and tell them it's been nobody but God. Shake the other person's hand or shake their neighbor's hand again and wake them up and tell them it's been nobody but God. Guys, thank you, Jesus.
If you ever hear two men in the background that just can't let it go, it's because they were sprung out for years. And ain't touched it in over 20-something years now. They got something to shout about. And guess what? When they start shouting, we ought to help them shout. Because it's been nobody. Oh, it's been nobody. Help that shout.
He protect us from moonstroke and sunstroke. Remember that I gave you last right? See, sunstroke was dangerous. It was dangerous because your body became overheated and it would shut down. Y'all hearing me? And when your body shut down, that means your organs shut down. And when your organs shut down, you cannot live any longer. It becomes fatal. Do y'all not know that nobody in California dies from natural causes? On everybody's death certificate, it's causes. A, B, C, D, E. You do not read a death certificate line A, read line A, read line B, read line C, read line D, read line E. That's not how you read a death certificate. You read a death certificate back up. So whatever is in line E calls line D. Whatever is in line D calls line C. Whatever is in line C calls B. And whatever is in line B calls A. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? So whatever's at the bottom was the start of what would take you out of here. I wish I had somebody in here. And so when your organs shut down, you can no longer live. These are causes. That's on your death certificate. Ain't nobody talking back to me in here. And the Lord protects us from the element.
these soldiers from the element, because these soldiers, all of the soldiers, did not die. All of the travelers going to Passover did not die along the way. So this is validation to inform you that the Lord can keep you from sunstroke. I gotta go here, y'all. Some of y'all ain't got sunstroke. Some of y'all got crazy stroke. I made up another word. The Lord keeps us from our own crazy self. Okay, slow everywhere. I said the Lord keep us. Thank you, Nola. The Lord keeps us. Didn't I tell y'all? I told y'all put a pin there. I'm coming back. The Lord keeps us from ourselves sometimes. Some of y'all mad at yourself for something you did 10 years ago. Get over it. People don't even remember what you did 10 years ago. Some of y'all can't remember what you did yesterday, and today is just today. Let me talk to the people that's over 50. Have you ever been looking for your glasses and they were on your eyes or on your head? Or they were in your hands? And you go looking, you just look at all of the house, look at me like, oh, my glasses is on my face. I thought the over 50 crowd would help me. I had a pair of glasses that was missing for 2 weeks. Guess where I found them, y'all? On the back seat of my car. And Delilah, I was standing in my car and saying, how did they get here? I knew they were lost. I knew they was lost. That's just a victory thing, social media. I know the word is no. But I knew So he protects us from sunstroke, but not only do he protect us from sunstroke, he protects us from moonstroke. See, moonstroke didn't kill you, but it was meant to believe that mental health was caused by the moon in ancient days. Y'all ain't talking back to me here. See, where we get the word lunatic, it refers to someone who has a mental disturbance. This ain't the first time we see lunatic in the Bible. Luke was a physician, and that boy, that Mark, who's a preacher, said that he cut himself and he tried to drown himself.
Yeah, that's what he said.
You know, he's mentally challenged. Mm-hmm. Luke is a doctor. Luke prognosis is the one I'll take. Luke said, hey, y'all, this boy is a lunatic.
Right.
Luke said, this boy got some stuff going on.
Right.
Are y'all with me up in here? He ain't the only one. Some of us got some mental stuff going on.
Amen.
I don't know why y'all got quiet, because everybody in our family got somebody mental.
Amen.
You may not want everybody to know it, but everybody got somebody mental in your family. Okay. Y'all want me to go there? Oh, so y'all just gonna call my car? So y'all just gonna blame me like that? Okay, I'm gonna go there. That's why some of y'all didn't go to your family reunion this summer.
Right, my God.
Woo! Preach.
I'm not going, Doc. I'm not going.
Oh, that's out of the family.
No, it's a no. It's a no.
You know, mental sickness run on that side. It run on your side too, boo! At least 5 people that'll help me up in here.
Amen, Pastor.
Is mental health on your block? Is mental health up in this church?
Ooh, you ain't
I think
lying.
All of us should go sit on a Chase lounge and talk to somebody with some glasses on, with their leg crossed, with a yellow notebook and a pen, and talk to somebody.
Amen.
It's good to pray, but it's good to talk to somebody. Some of us been holding hate and frustration and misery in you for years, and all you're doing is hurting yourself even more. Because at some point you got to release that.
Amen.
Release it so you can live healthy.
Amen.
So, folks, need a pill to wake up, a pill to go to sleep, pill to keep you awake, a cannabis card to keep you energized. Amari, you like that one?
Oh, amen. Let's move on. Woo!
See what I mean about mental health in this church?
Amen, Pastor. You want it.
One day I'm not going to preach. I'm just going to have somebody just go to every role and talk to everybody individually one Sunday. And you're going to believe it. Did not our hearts burn within? Text us from the enemy and the element. I'm out of here, y'all. First thing I told you, y'all, was the Creator will help us. The second thing I told you, His courage will strengthen us. I'm finished, y'all. This is it for this sermon right here. Number 4, verse 7 and 8, He will continue to preserve us.
Amen.
The Creator will help us. His courage will strengthen us. But I'm closing right here, y'all, with number 3. He will continue to preserve us.
Amen.
Verse 7 and 8, the Lord shall, here it is right here, preserve your going out and your coming in from this time forth. And even forevermore.
Yes.
Amen.
I'll get to that forevermore in a minute, y'all. Here it is, right here. He will continue to preserve us. Verse 7, what is he preserving us from? Can I preach it?
Yeah, go ahead.
I told you I can't lie too many times, guys. Because you see children like she ready to go. What will he preserve us from? Right. It's in the Bible. It's in the Bible, right? Verse 7. The Lord will preserve you from all evil. Yes. That's it right there.
Thank
you. What will he preserve you from? Evil!
Yes. That's good.
Because sometimes we are around some evil people.
Yes.
Yeah. Ever since Nicole left here, I've been dealing with evil people. People die. Some people do some of the most stupid, incompetent things.
Amen.
Never.
Yeah, you're right.
Up and you're all right.
And it ain't nothing but God on the inside to keep you from going gospel gangster. Death changed people.
Amen.
And I ain't talking about changing for the good. I'm talking about it changing to make them do some crazy, evil, wicked things. Some diabolical stuff. You be like, are you saved? You go to church? You say you love God? What's how you act? I wish I had somebody talking to me.
What's wrong with you?
See, y'all, he preserves us from evil. Why? Because our bodies, y'all ready for this? Watch this, Dante. You're gonna like this.
I'm with you.
Our bodies are nothing but some volcanoes.
That was for me.
Our bodies are nothing but some volcanoes, and at any moment, sin can burst forth. We can go off at any moment. We can curse at any moment. We can say anything at any moment. We can get a smoke at any moment. We can get a drink at any moment. We'll give up on God on any moment. You'll turn your back on people at any moment. You'll do this at any moment. You'll do some things that you said you would never do, because we're nothing but some built up volcanoes. More help in here, a little more volume in here.
That was good.
That was it.
That was for me, right there.
When that volcano erupts, we can commit any sin imaginable.
My God. My God.
My God.
That's why you gotta be careful. Oh, I would never do that. You don't know.
Talk about it.
let the reason why you say, y'all ready? If I, Omari, watch this. If I don't say anything else, you don't get anything else I say, and they get this. One of the only reasons why you say that you would never do that is because you ain't never had an offer yet.
Oh my God. Wow.
Never had an offer. Woo! Wow. I would never do that. Ain't nobody offering it to
you. You ain't even had the opportunity.
You don't know what you would do when the opportunity opens. And all of us don't go through a good door. Because some of us, you know, we like bad boys. Ladies. Now, ladies don't like church boys because, you know, some jump off. You know, you think they're going to start praying, but you need somebody that's going to throw.
They dang.
See, I know Auntie Mary would like that. She like bad boys. She always liked that one. Nephew, I like that.
Yes. Yes. Oh, wow.
But can't y'all find somebody got a little gospel in them?
Amen.
And a little ghetto in them? They like
G&G.
Get Bible. They like.
What is he trying to
do? Get by. He's get by.
See?
Yeah, get. GHETTBIBLE. Get by.
Okay, get by.
See, I used to be slow too.
Used to be.
Yeah, they got it. When I spelled it out, they got it. Okay. See, y'all, the flesh will deprive us. Okay, look at Romans 7:18. Can I have a few more minutes? Sure, I'm coming. Yeah, I'm coming. Look at Romans chapter 7, verse 18. I know. I told you, it's your day today. Look at Romans chapter 7. But that's after church, it's your day. Gotta get Jesus in first. Before we get bumpy jumping. Y'all ready for this one? Uh-huh. Auntie Mary, you gonna like this one. You should highlight this one in your Bible. This one fits you.
It fits you.
Nola, this fits you too. Here. Auntie Angie, join in as well.
She's a wild right there. She's
a wild. Y'all ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Mama, what are you doing over there? First, you're making me nervous, Mama. Look at verse 16. Romans 7:16. Y'all there? Listen. I ain't got no more points until right
there. Amen.
Yeah. All right. That's you, Mama Blake?
No.
Oh. Okay. Vin, I'm Michelle, man. All right, let me just, since nobody won't fess up, let me.
She's still hurting. I am crying.
Romans chapter 7. Let's look at verse 15. Verse 15, Romans chapter 7, verse 15. This is right here, y'all. Auntie Mary, you got it?
I'm writing it down.
Okay, you're writing it down. It's going to help you. For what I am doing, I do not understand. For what I will to do, that I do not practice. But what I hate, I do.
Yeah.
Wow.
Why would Sean Sheldon, I wish I'd have bought the Good News Study Bible. I look at verse 16. If then I do what I will not to do, I agree with the law that is good. Verse 17. But now it is no longer I who do it, but sin that dwells in me.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Verse 18. For I know that in me, that is my flesh. Mm. Nothing good dwells, for to will is present with me, but how to perform what is good, I do not find.
Help me.
for the good that I will to do, I do not do. But the evil I will not to do, that I practice.
Right.
Woo!
Ain't no good in us. Now, do y'all get this? Do y'all understand what I said about we ain't nothing but some volcanoes?
Yeah.
Paul says that the stuff that I'm supposed to be doing, I don't do.
Right, my God.
And the stuff that I'm supposed to stay away from, that's the stuff that draws me. And then if you keep reading, he goes on to say, me is a man of unclean lips. Oh, wretched man that I am. That's why we can't stay out of church. That's why we can't stay away from praying. That's why we can't stay away from Bible class.
Y'all ain't talking back to me. Yeah.
Because we need each other. That's that flesh. The old folk call it the flush. That's that flush. That old flush can get the best of us. That flush ain't no good. That's why it's easy for some of us to go off. Let me help you. When you get saved, the devil did not stop bothering you. I know. 1 Corinthians 5:17. If any man or woman be in Christ Jesus, he's a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things come new. It didn't say old things left.
My God. Yeah, it ain't going nowhere.
You just suppressed them a little bit. And at any given time, that old flesh,
yeah,
that old flesh
could rise and take over that new nature. That's why it makes no sense to talk about you got new fingers and new hands and new weeds and new nails if you ain't got a new heart. Because the old heart will tell all that new stuff what to do, where to go, where to get off at. You gotta know how to crucify your flesh. All day long, I've been with Jesus. All day long. You got to be with Jesus all day long.
Yeah.
I woke up this morning with my mind stayed on Jesus. Not on your boo.
Not on your boo.
Not on babe. Snookum, sugar. Because when all of those names leave, you still got Jesus. And he'll never leave you. He'll never disappoint you. He'll never set you up for failure. He'll never throw rocks and hide his hands. He'll always be right there for you. Even when you don't feel him, who left who?
I'm finished. Just about 2 more minutes. Hit us right. I'm sorry.
Come on, Julie.
Watch this, y'all. She upset.
You talking about she?
There's a little turbulence in that area. I'm gonna walk around. Watch this. Hear this right. Let me hear the finishes. Hear this right, y'all. Do y'all know? Watch this, and I'm finished. Y'all get with me so we can go to bumpity jumping. Hit this right here. Do y'all know? Listen, hit this. Do y'all know it takes no effort at all to sin?
Right.
It don't take no effort at all to sin. Why does it not take any sin. Watch this, y'all. Because we were bent in that direction when we were born. Man that's born of a woman is a few days, and those days are full of trouble. We were born with a bent towards sin. I pressed toward the mark for the prize of the high calling in Jesus. Why? Because I got a little bent. And some of us like the bend.
Watch it now.
We good at bending.
My God.
Yeah.
Help us, Holy Ghost.
But he'll protect us from the evil one.
Yes. Thank you, God. Thank you.
Cast your cares upon him, for he careth for you. This is your last supper. He preserve us from evil, y'all. But watch this. Hear this right here, y'all. Verse 8. For the Lord shall preserve you from your going out and your coming in. Hear this right here, y'all. From the time forth and even forevermore. So he'll protect you from evil, but he'll preserve you from evil. But then lastly, y'all, and I'm finished. He'll preserve you for eternity.
Amen.
Amen.
For eternity.
The psalmist reminds us that the Lord will keep us while we're on earth. And he will continue to keep us. Because our relationship with God is priceless. It's priceless. It's priceless. Not only is it priceless, but it's endless. Not only is it priceless, not only is it endless, but it's guaranteed. He says, I'll keep you from this moment forth. Just drop the four. Forever. It's like somebody you get ready to go to jail for a long time. They don't say, how long are you going to be there? Forever. No, they just say, ever. Y'all catch that tomorrow. Because in Jesus, he preserves us forever. Father, thank you for your word. Thank you, God, that you are keeping us and you're holding us and you're helping us. And your word is healing us. God, it's my prayer that after today we will be better. And we'll always look to this Psalm 121, because we shall look to the hills from which cometh our help. Our help coming from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Preserve us and keep us, God. Hold us in the palm of your hand. Don't let us succumb to the devil. But let us say yes to your will, yes to your way, yes to your word. And we'll always be in good standing with you. Thank you now for another opportunity to minister your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
The Bible says in Romans chapter 10 and verse 9 that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in thine heart that God raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Romans chapter 10 verse 17 says, so faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. The Bible says in Romans chapter 3 and verse 23, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. The Bible also says in Romans chapter 6 verse 23, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. Acts chapter 16 verse 30, verse 31 said, what must I do to be saved? Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and you shall be saved. Well, if you forget Romans chapter 10, verse 9, if you forget Romans chapter 10, verse 17, if you forget Romans 6, 23, Romans 3, 23, Acts chapter 16, verse 30 and 31, Bible says in John 3, 16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
I don't know where you are. You could be in your break room. You could be at home. You could be in the kitchen. You could be driving in your car. You could be watching us on YouTube, Facebook, or Instagram. And you want to make Jesus your choice. It's easy. It's like ABC. Accept him, believe him, and confess him.
Yes.
And the Lord will come into your life. If any man or woman be in Christ Jesus, he or she is a new creature. Old things are passed away, and behold, all things have become new. If you want to give your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, right at the bottom of your screen, there is a number, 510-575-9092. Please call that number or text that number. Say, I want to be saved. Leave a message. Leave a number so that I can call you back and go over to Plan of Salvation with you and give you information about our church. If you want to become a virtual member of Victory, you're more than welcome. You do not have to live in Oakland to become a virtual member of the Victory Baptist Church. You can be all over the country and you can become a virtual member of the Victory Church. Is my prayer, if you want to accept Jesus Christ into your life, into your heart, you can't make it without him. You need him in your life. Life is too short. Life is unexpected. But everything, nothing is a surprise. Nothing is a surprise. Nothing is a surprise to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
He holds this world in the palm of his hand. He knows the past, the present, and the future. He knows our days are numbered. He knows the dash in between your sunrise and your sunset. And the Lord will preserve you and protect you. And he will give you salvation. That's my prayer for you. May the Lord bless you and may the Lord keep you. All right, inside of the building and outside of the building, those of you on social media, right at the left side of your screen is our safe and secure giving mechanisms. We are passing out envelopes in the building right now, and those of you get ready to give with the giving mechanisms right there on your screen. We appreciate you all for joining us today. Again, we apologize for a bad internet day. It's happening kind of often. We pray that it won't happen much longer when we get in our own home.
Amen.
All right, we are passing out envelopes. Let us prepare to give. Today is the first Sunday. Let us do the Lord's tithes and offerings at this moment. And then we're going to do our special offering after that. Given, we bless you and thank you for worshiping with us one more Sunday. It is time to say goodbye or see you later to those of you out in social media land. The Lord bless thee and keep thee. I'm praying for you, and Pastor Marty loves you. Have a great day.
Hey everybody, and we thank you for joining in into the Victory Baptist Church worship today. We pray that you were blessed, and we pray that the Lord met your need in today's worship. Our prayer is that you will come back next Sunday at 12 p.m. and join us again for another wonderful, incredible service. Be blessed, and thank you for watching.